get ready to go. We're glad that you're all here, so now it's time to start the show. We're not in school, but we can still pretend by making music until this ends. We're making music with our Falcon friends.
Hey Falcons, hope you guys had a great week. It's Mr. B. And we're here to make some music with our Falcon friends again. This week we've got some all new things to do with you. I've got a new song to teach to you. Mrs. Dundor has got some brand new rhythms to read with you. Mrs. Castle has a couple of great songs to listen to. And Mr. Small has a really fun activity at the end of our episode today. So, let's stop talking and let's make some music, shall we?
Making music
with our Falcon friends. Well, hello again. Fourth grade, we got a new song for you today. It's by a man named William. Now, William isn't just any old guy. William has a very interesting family because William doesn't have one son or two sons or even three sons. William has got seven different sons. I'm going to sing. I want you to echo back. Take a listen.
William, he has seven sons, seven sons, seven sons. William, he had seven sons, and this is what they did.
Let's learn that part first. I'll sing, you echo back.
William, he had seven sons. Seven sons, seven sons. William, he had seven sons. And this is what they did.
Nice job. Let's sing the whole first part. I'll sing it once, then you sing it back for me. Take a listen.
William, he had seven sons, seven sons, seven sons. William, he had seven sons, and this is what they did.
Your turn. Now, each of William's seven different sons has something that they like to do. I want you to listen because the melody is the same, the music is the same. The only thing that's changing is his son and what they like to do. Take a listen, I'll sing the first one.
The first one liked to ride a bike, ride a bike, ride a bike. The first one liked to ride a bike, and that is what he did.
See how that works? It's very similar. It's the same melody, same music. The only thing that's changing are the words. Ride a bike. Can you sing it with me?
The first one liked to ride a bike, ride a bike, ride a bike. The first one liked to ride a bike, and that is what he did.
Second son likes to do something different. Take a listen.
The second one liked to drive a car, drive a car, drive a car. The second one liked to drive a car, and that is what he did.
Let's sing that one together. Second one, driving a car. Here we go.
The second one liked to drive a car, drive a car, drive a car. The second one liked to drive a car, and that is what he did.
Now, the third one, I think you figured out how the song goes. I'm just going to tell you what it is, and we're going to see if we can sing it together. The third one liked to fly a plane. Can we sing it together?
The third one liked to fly a plane, fly a plane, fly a plane. Like to fly a plane, and that is what he did.
Nice job. Fourth one, like to sail the seas. Sing it with me.
The fourth one, like to sail the seas, sail the seas, sail the seas. The fourth one, like to sail the seas, and that is what he did.
Fifth one, like to drive a train.
The fifth one, like to drive a train, drive a train.
Sixth one liked to ride the bus.
The sixth one liked to ride the bus, ride the bus, ride the bus. The sixth one liked to ride the bus, and that is what he did.
Do you notice something all these have in common? Riding a bus and driving a train and flying a plane and sailing seas. You know what they all have in common? Yes, they all are very expensive hobbies, but not just that. They're all modes of transportation. They're all different ways you can get around. Can you think of one that we could do for the seventh son? Think of one that we could do for the seventh son. What's another type of transportation that we haven't listed yet? What's that I hear? somewhere way in the back. I think I'm hearing it. What? Ride a motorcycle? You want to try that? I'm not sure if it'll fit, but let's give it a shot. The seventh one, like to ride a motorcycle, ride a motorcycle, ride a motorcycle. Seventh one, like to ride a motorcycle, and that is what he did. It was a mouthful, but it worked. Nice job. At the end, we'll finish it like we started it. William, he had seven sons, seven sons, seven sons. William, he had seven sons, and that is what they did. Nice job, guys. Hey, quick question. That song, does it sound like a really happy song, or does it actually sound a little, kind of a little sad, a little bit on the melancholy side? What do you think? It does sound a little sad. I agree. I'm assuming you said that. I actually don't know because I can't hear you because this is a YouTube video. But if you said sad, I agree with you. And I know what you're thinking. Why would this song sound sad? Well, there's a very good reason for that. If you had seven sons and they all had such expensive hobbies, you'd probably be pretty sad too. All right. Hey, we'll see you next time, guys. Thanks for singing.
We're making music with our Falcon friends.
Hey, Falcons. Are you ready to read some music? I know I am. Make sure you grab your music notation paper that you used for last week's melody. Looks like this. If you can't find it, or you want a new one, you can find a copy of the paper in this week's resources in the folder called Music Reading with Mrs. Dundor. Don't forget a pencil, too. All right, I'm going to quickly remind you how to do this, and then we're just going to jump right into it. Here's this week's melody. If you remember or already know how to do this, pause the video and write down your answers. If you need a refresher, just keep on watching before you pause. 1. Write down the rhythmic syllables, like ta and toddy, on your paper. Make sure you write down the correct ones according to the rhythm. Also make sure that you write them in the correct measures. 2. Write down the counting. Check your time signature first so that you know how many beats go in each measure. 3. Write down the letters of the melody. Remember the three questions to identifying a note. Is the note on a line or a space? What is the easy way to remember the lines or spaces? And what's the note? Now, pause the video and write down your answers. When you're ready to check how you've done, play it again. Here are your answers for this week's melody. How did you do? Pause the video to check your work. Now it's time to play. So grab the nearest instrument, or use your hands, and let's play the melody. This week, I'm using a mason jar. I can just tap on top, and it kind of sounds like a drum. First, we're going to play and say the rhythmic syllables. Play along with me. Ready, go. Ta-dee-ta, ta. Rest. Ta-dee-ta, ta. Next, we're going to play and count. Ready, go. One and two. One, two, one, and two, one, two. And finally, we're going to play and say the letters. Ready, go. C, C, E, C. Rest. D, B, C, C. Great job, everyone. Now remember to keep that paper safe so that you can reuse it for next week's melody. I would love to see how you guys are doing with these melodies. So make a video of yourself playing and saying this melody. You can send it to me at makingmusicfalconfriends@gmail.com. I'll put that right here for you. makingmusicfalconfriends@gmail.com. You never know. Your video could end up on one of our episodes. For more information on how to send me a video, I've listed specific directions in this week's resource folder on Schoology labeled Music Reading with Mrs. Dundor. After the episode, check out the links that are also in that folder. Just 5 minutes a day and you'll be reading music so much faster than you ever thought you could. Well, that's it for me today. Bye, Falcons!
We're making music with our Falcon friends.
Hi everyone, this is Mrs. Castle coming to you with your weekly music listening lesson. Just a quick reminder that any resources and links that you may need for the week will be posted in the resources folder in the section titled Listening with Mrs. Castle. For this week's listening lesson, you will need the YouTube playlist open on another tab, the London Symphony Orchestra link open on an additional tab, and a printed out version of the PDF provided along with some crayons or colored pencils. If you don't have access to a printer, you can just follow along with it on your laptop. The first listening exercise you will be doing this week is an interactive performance by the London Symphony Orchestra. When you open the link, you will see four different views of the orchestra as they play Shostakovich's Fifth Symphony. If you click on each of the views, you can change the view of the orchestra to see a different set of sections or even a different view of the section you're already looking at. This Fifth Symphony is a long piece of music, so don't feel like you need to watch the whole thing. I would highly encourage you to listen to at least the first part of it, as it's an amazing piece of music. Go ahead and get started when you're ready.
We're making music with our Falcon friends.
How incredible is that website? I love being able to see the different parts of the orchestra during a live performance, but sometimes you don't get that when you're watching a concert via live stream. For our second listening exercise, you will need that YouTube playlist, the provided PDF, either printed out or just pulled up on your screen, and some crayons or colored pencils. This piece, which is part of Bach's Brandenburg Concertos, requires you to do some coloring while listening. If you don't have access to a printed out version of the PDF, just follow along and think about how you would color the different parts of our picture. Take a quick minute to look at the PDF to see what you're listening for, pull up that YouTube link, and get to work.
We're making music with our Falcon friends.
Great work! Sometimes I find that I listen better to a piece of music while working on something that focuses my listening, just like you were doing with that picture, whether you were coloring it or following along on your laptop with each part of the song. Well, that's all I have for this week. See you next week for some more music listening with me, Mrs. Castle.
We're making music with our Falcon friends.
Hello, great to have you here with me again for Activities with Mr. Small. Just like in episode one, I'm going to build off of a song that Mr. Bridenstine taught you this week. And let's review it first. It goes, William, he had seven sons, seven sons, seven sons. William, he had seven sons, and this is what they did. Now, if you didn't sing it with me that time, let's try it together if you were just listening for review. Here we go. Ready? Sing. William, he had seven sons, seven sons, seven sons. William, he had seven sons, and this is what they did. All right, good memory. Now, I'm going to do improvisation with you this week on this song. Improvisation is when you make something up on the fly. So I'm not going to give you time to think about it. And what you're going to do is make up something that the seven sons are doing. So next verse is going to be, the first one liked to ride a bike, ride a bike, ride a bike. The first one liked to ride a bike, and that is what he did. Now, I filled it in with ride a bike, ta-dee-ta. Let's clap, ta-dee-ta, ready, go. Again, and go. Now, let's tap, ride a bike, ready, go. Ready, go. So it has to fit the rhythm, but it's going to be on the fly. Don't think about it too much. Just come up with something. Sometimes it might be something silly that fits into that space, but it's got to match ta-dee-ta. And then you have to repeat it for that entire verse, just like I did with Ride a Bike. So again, here's what the first new verse sounded like. The first one liked to ride a bike, ride a bike, ride a bike. The first one liked to ride a bike, and that is what he did. Now, it's going to sound like this when I play it for you. The first one liked to. The first one liked to. And that is what he did. And your job is to fill in the. The first one liked to. And you have to fill in those spots with whatever you come up with, whatever you improvise. So let's give it a try. I'm going to start with the first one, and I'm going to go straight through to the seventh one. Each time we move on to a new son, you cannot repeat the last thing that you did, the thing that you improvised. So here we go. Fill in the blanks. The first one liked to. The first one liked to. And that is what he did. The second one liked to. The second one liked to. And that is what what he did. The third one liked to. The third one liked to. And that is what he did. The fourth one liked to. The fourth one liked to. And that is what he did. The fifth one liked to. The fifth one liked to. And that is what he did. The sixth one liked to. The sixth one liked to. And that is what he did. The seventh one liked to. The seventh one liked to. And that is what he did. And if you want to do that again, rewind, go back, and see how many different things you can come up with that would fit in that ta-dee-ta space. Thanks for joining me this week, and I sure hope to see you next week.
We're making music with our Falcon friends.
Well, we sure had fun today, didn't we? Hopefully you had as much fun as we did. But it's time to go. So until next time, there's really only one thing left to say.
We'll meet again. I don't know where, don't know when, but I know we'll meet again some sunny day. Keep smiling through, just as you always do, till the blue skies drive the dark clouds far away. So will you please say hello to the folks that I know? Tell them I won't be long. They'll be happy to know that as you saw me go, I was singing this song. We'll meet again, don't know where, don't know when, but I know we'll meet again some sunny day.
See you next time, guys.
See you next time.
See you next time.
See you next time.